Down in the valley, two by two, my baby two by two, my baby two by two. Down in the valley, two by two, come on and rise, Sally, rise. Down in the valley, two by two, my baby two by two, my baby two by two. Down in the valley, two by two, come on and rise, Sally, rise. Let me see you make a motion, two by two, my baby two by two, my baby two by two. Let me see you make a motion, two by two, come on and rise, Sally, rise. Let me see you pick a partner, two by two, my baby two by two, my baby two by two. Let me see you pick a partner, two by two, come on and rise, Sally, rise. Down in the valley, two by two, my baby two by two, my baby two by two. Down in the valley, two by two, come on and rise, Sally, rise. Let me see you make a motion, two by two, my baby two by two, my baby two by two. Let me see you make a motion, two by two, come on and rise, Sally, rise. Let me see you pick a partner, two by two, my baby two by two, my baby two by two. Let me see you pick a partner, two by two, come on and rise, Sally, rise. Down in the valley, two by two, my baby two by two, my baby two by two. Down in the valley, two by two, come on and rise, Sally, rise.
Down in the valley one morning, the turtle was walking along, and the turtle was just a-talking to himself. And I guess the reason why the turtle was talking to himself because the turtle felt that nobody really paid him any attention. You see, the turtle was smaller than the other animals, and the turtle had this shell on his back, therefore that made him a little slower. But the turtle kept on mumbling and grumbling to himself, and finally he said out loud, "I am somebody."
"Say what?" said the crocodile.
"I say I am somebody," said the turtle.
"You ain't nobody," said the crocodile. "And if you come over here just a little bit closer, I'm going to prove it to you."
Well, just then, the turtle backed a little ways off. He didn't want to get too close to that crocodile because he knew exactly what that crocodile meant. Now, the turtle kept on walking along, and then he began to hear the elephant and the hippopotamus talking. And they were talking about an election coming up. And they were saying how they were going to both run for judges.
Said the turtle. "You know, I see no reason why I shouldn't be a judge also. I am smart. I can make decisions, and I think that I would make a wonderful judge." And so the turtle ran for office. But you know what happened? Two judges were elected, hippopotamus and the elephant. And the poor turtle, he was just considered a laughing stock, and all the animals laughed at him. But this did not stop the turtle. Oh no. The turtle thought of a little idea, of a little way that he would show not only the elephant and the hippopotamus, but he was going to show everyone in the jungle, just how smart he was. He decided to go over and visit the elephant. So the next morning, he went along. "Two-way, two-way, barima, two-way, 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 barima, two-way, two-way, la 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 la, two-way, two-way, la 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 la, two-way, two-way. Hello, elephant. How are you doing today? Who is that speaking to me?
It's me, your friend," said the turtle.
"Who? Who is that? Who is that way down there speaking to me?"
"It's me," said the turtle. "I'm way down here, elephant."
"What? How dare you speak to me," said the elephant. "How dare you call me friend? You're not my friend. Stomp you out."
Wait a minute, friend.
"Don't call me friend," said the elephant. "You're not my friend." "Wait a minute. Now just calm down," said the turtle.
"Now listen here, elephant. I see no reasons why we can't be friends. I am just as strong as you are, and I am just as smart as you are.
Say what, said the elephant?
You think you are as strong, you think you are as smart as I am?
Well, said the elephant, just watch this. And the elephant began to stomp around.
He took his trunk, he wrapped it around a tree, and he pulled that whole tree up by its roots. Boom!
Now, can you do that, said the elephant?
No, said the turtle. Now you see, friend, I wouldn't want to do that. Look what you've done. You have just hurt all those tiny little birds. I wouldn't want to do that, said the turtle. But I'll tell you what, friend. Why don't you and I have a little contest, a little tug-of-war contest?
Okay, said the turtle.
Said the elephant. What is this tug-of-war contest?
Well, all you have to do is this. I have here my binding rope. I want you to take one end of it, and I am going to go to the far end of the jungle, and I am going to hold on to the other end. Now, if you can pull me over, you will win. If I can pull you over, I will win. And then we will see who is the strongest, okay?
Said the elephant. Sounds okay to me.
And so the turtle went to the farther end of the jungle, but not to hold the rope.
Oh, no.
He went over to visit the hippopotamus. And when he got there, the hippopotamus was bathing in the river.
Hello, friend. How are you doing?
Who is that speaking to me? Who is that?
It's me, the turtle. It's me, your friend.
Who is that calling me friend? Turtle? How dare you call me friend? You are no friend of mine. I ought to come down there and eat you.
Wait a minute. Calm down, hippopotamus. Just calm down now. I see no reasons why we can't be friends, seeing how I am just as strong and just as wise as you are.
Huh?
Turtle, you think you are as smart as I am?
I have never heard something as funny in all my life.
Why, just watch me, said the hippopotamus. And the hippopotamus jumped out of the river, and it began to strut around.
Boom, 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 boom.
Now, can you do that? Can you make that loud sound, said the hippopotamus?
Now, wait a minute, said the turtle. I don't want to make that loud sound because I don't want to scare anybody.
But I'll tell you what, friend. Why don't you and I have a little tug-of-war contest, okay?
Said the hippopotamus. What is this tug-of-war contest?
I tell you what. I have with me my binding rope. I want you to take one end of it, and I am going to go to the far side of the forest, and I am going to hold the other end of the rope. Now, when I give it a tug, I want you to pull, okay? And if you can pull me over, you win. If I can pull you over, I win, okay?
Said the hippopotamus. Okay, I will give this game of yours a try, turtle.
And so the turtle went not to the far end of the jungle, but he went in the middle of the rope. He looked way down there at the elephant, and naturally the elephant couldn't see who was pulling on the other end. He looked way down there at the hippopotamus, but naturally the hippopotamus couldn't see who was pulling on the other end. And so the turtle gave the rope a little tug. Now the elephant, not thinking anything, thinking that little old silly turtle was on the other end, not paying any attention, just holding on the rope very, very casually, until all of a sudden,
said the elephant. This turtle is stronger than I thought he was. The elephant was trying to hold on as hard as he could. And the hippopotamus, help, said the hippopotamus, help. Oh, I'm being pulled across the water. Help.
And the turtle, said the turtle, you know, I'm getting hungry. And the turtle began to eat his little lunch. Oh,
said the turtle. I'm getting so tired. I think I will take a little nap. Said the turtle, waking up. Ooh, I must have been asleep for a couple of hours or so. You know, I wonder if those two animals are still pulling on that rope. And sure enough, the elephant was just pulling away. And the hippopotamus was just pulling away. Well, said the turtle, I guess I better cut that rope. The turtle took out a knife, began to cut, and snap, boom, bang, boom, 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 boom. Oh my goodness, said the turtle, it sounds like an earthquake. Trees were shaking, water was splashing everywhere. The turtle ran as fast as he could to see if the elephant was okay. But when he got there, the elephant had fallen on his head. Ooh, 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 I have a headache, said the elephant. Ooh, ooh. Oh, friend, let me see what I can do, said the turtle. And so the turtle went over to a tree and got some juju juice. And he began to wipe it on the elephant's head. Oh, 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 I feel so much better. Oh, thank you. Turtle, you are much stronger than I thought you were. You know, I need somebody like you on my side. I think we should become friends. It's okay with me, said the turtle. And they shook hands, and so the turtle became friends with the elephant. Well, said the turtle, I guess I better go and see if the hippopotamus is okay. So the turtle went as fast as he could, but you must remember he's kind of slow. He went as fast as he could over to the hippopotamus, and the poor hippopotamus had landed right on his hip. Ooh, 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 my hip, my hip, my hip. Oh, wait a minute, said the turtle. Let me get some of my mojo juice over here, and I will rub it on your hip. And that is what the turtle did. And the hippopotamus felt so much better. Oh, 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 thank you, turtle. Thank you very much. You know, turtle, you're much stronger than I thought you were, and I need somebody like you on my side. I think we should become friends. And that is how the turtle became friends with the hippopotamus. Now I have a question to ask you. Which animal was the strongest animal? Some of you may say the elephant. Well, the elephant is a strong animal. And some of you will say the hippopotamus. Well, the hippopotamus is a strong animal. But those of you who say the turtle was the strongest animal, you're right. And do you know why? Well, the other two animals had great strength, but the turtle had common sense. And common sense is always stronger than great strength.